Hey guys, welcome back to a new episode of the Brenz podcast. What I want to talk to you about today is what we are living right now, from confinement stress, instability, and uncertainty. And before we get into it, as always, I take this time to remind you to subscribe to the channel and hit the thumbs up to support us to create more content and activate the notification bell to get the latest. And without further ado, let's dive in. As you all know, the country has been on lockdown since March 20th, 2020. Until this day, we still don't know what's gonna happen or where we are going, as there is no light at the end of our tunnel. And every time we think we got close to the finish line, we find that there is still more grounds to cover. We can't tell really how much, as we are in a passenger seat, just watching as a sport spectators cheering for their players, telling them to pass or shoot while they'll behave like they can't even hear ya. People are getting frustrated, not knowing what to do, especially in the private sector. It suffered immensely. Employees got fired due to lack of sales or no sales at all when you are not legally allowed to open. Some haven't opened their shops till this day, fearing for their lives or the lives of their loved ones. Many factories stopped producing due to no supply of raw materials. And when we flip to the other side of the coin, the public sector is protected against all catastrophic events like these. When you go to public administrations, like less than 70% of workers are occupying their posts, while the rest are homesick, fearful, or enjoying the ride. We will not succeed like that. This is a simple mind thinking, and no progress has been achieved through this behavior. Correct me if I'm wrong. I don't know. I guess to this point, every one of us has been affected by the pandemic or know someone close who got infected. Sickness everywhere we look. That forces us to doubt ourselves and be uncertain about life itself. And if we go to the hospital, it's a different story. You all have seen the pictures. The question we should ask: how do we focus on our targets and not get confused or derailed? Because I know a lot of people have lost their way in times like these. As they keep thinking the world is gonna end, they switch to spectator mode, waiting for the dust to settle. After many months, they find themselves behind. It comes much harder for them to keep up with the speed when this all ends. In times like these, we should focus on things we wanted to do but didn't get around to doing them, like learning a new instrument, learn programming, or even reading a book or listening to an audiobook. We want to be wise about our choices, because life will resume and we will be asked, what did we do during the peak of the pandemic? People should focus more on learning, creating, or inventing, upgrading their lives, earning more money, as this is the best time to get ahead. You may know that already. You see, there is enough nonsense going on in the world right now. When you turn on the news, it's the same everywhere. War, pandemic, famine, betrayals, elections, and a lot more. Too many things to keep up with. That's why we should focus on the self-improvement and upgrading ourselves. We want to see opportunities again. We want to see life. We want to go to the beach and spend the whole day relaxing and swimming, not giving a damn about the world. There is too much to do, and yet we are still on household. Many countries have resumed business already, as usual, taking cautionary measures to ensure the safety of their citizens. It's true that they have taken a hit or two, as the rest of the world, but they know things must open again, and we are still waiting for the unknown to be cleared. We hope things will be better to normal sooner. Thank you guys for listening. I hope you enjoyed the episode. Tell me what you think in the comments below. And I'll be back inshallah with more videos.